ladies and gentlemen, please give a huge round of applause for your groom. Look. I wish I'd never met them 2 points of Stella. On behalf of my wife and I.
Oh!
Took her a long time to become a Williams, you know. I would like to start by thanking everyone here today for sharing our very special day with us. Thank you all for the wonderful gifts and cards that you've given us. I can safely say it wouldn't have been the same without you all.
That's all right, Luke, anytime.
Even though it would have been a lot cheaper. I'd like to say thank you to John and Liz for your beautiful daughter.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I want to thank you for taking me into this lovely family. It really does mean a lot to me. Most importantly, for raising such an amazing, beautiful woman. She really does mean the world to me. She's absolutely beautiful.
So are you.
Thank you. I'd also like to thank my parents who have put up with me for all these years. They've both been there for me when I needed to give it. They give me a wonderful start in life, and I'm very fortunate and very proud to have a mum and dad like them. I've got a present for her. About car flowers. He's coming.
Even
let
me cry now.
My mum hasn't cried, so it hasn't done the job. I would also like to thank a few people who couldn't be here today, because without them, this wedding wouldn't have even happened. So I'd like to thank Bet365, William Hill, Coral, and not forgetting Ladbrokes. I really wish they could have been here. They don't like me. I'd also like to thank the bridesmaids. You all look amazing today. It wouldn't have been the same without you helping my beautiful bride today, so thank you. Aww. I'd also like to thank Anita for doing all the dresses. I really do appreciate your hard work that you've put into doing them dresses today. I've got a little present for you as well. Yeah, both a big bow of pear flowers.
Put your hand up and eat
us. Yes, that's not my word for that. But unfortunately, it's not been possible to have everyone here with us today. But we know they're here with us in spirit. They're not only in our thoughts today, but most importantly, they're here with us in our hearts. Our Uncle Bobby lost his fight to cancer 4 days ago, so not forgetting my sister Rachel, and also Shan's cousin Claire, which means a lot to her. So with them in mind, I'd like to all please and stand and raise a glass and join me in a toast. To our absent friends and family. Finally, I'd like to just thank you all again for coming today. It really does mean a lot to us. I'm going to pass you over to my brother. Oh, hang on a minute. We've got some flowers for Sarah to help and shine out today. Thanks a lot, Sarah. Nah, thanks for helping shine out today. I've also got a bouquet of flowers for Shan's mom Joan and my nan. Thanks a lot, Joan.
This is
disappointing.
Yes, it's my man over
there.
So, Adam, what are you going to say?
It's okay, I'm missing.
Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls. Because anybody here is feeling a bit worried or apprehensive, you're either me or because you've just married Luke. Only joking, Shane. Although now I look at you, jokes aside, you look beautiful today. I'd planned for this speech to last around 30 minutes. But to be honest, I was desperate to find out what horse won the 1530 at Chantelle. So if anybody would like to know the result, I'll be resting on the bar, probably drowning my sorrows. In case you haven't guessed it, the reason I'm sitting here now is because I am the best man. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Adam, Luke's older brother. I know you'll be shocked by that sentence. But what can you say about a man who came from humble beginnings, who's now quickly rising to be the best plaster in the business, even though I'm now on a waiting list. He has grit, willpower, he pushes to where other people have fallen, always bends over backwards to help anybody, offers support and advice to all his family and friends, who know, and a man who nobody can say a bad word against.
Is that really him?
power of the internet, is that Google is for honest. So anyway, that's enough about that nice fellow. What we're really here to talk about is Luke. Luke's always been a rock to me, and especially over the last few months. I wanted to write the very best speech for him and spend a long time researching what makes the perfect best man speech. In my quest for perfection, and everybody knows Luke's got some serious OCD, I've been told that my speech should contain details of our relationship, so here goes. Luke has always been a big brother to me, so he beat me up, blamed me for everything. He broke, he stole my stuff, he sabotaged my plans, and generally made life unbearable. Anyway, it's a great honour to be best man today, and maybe a bit of payback. There's always been a bit of competition to be the perfect son. Luke has been a little bit of a wild child, the sort of kid that mum and dad told me to keep away from. Always a little bit awkward when it's your brother. Other than the bride and groom themselves, I don't think anybody here is more happy to see Luke get married than our parents. They've been amazing role models for me and Luke. They've been married for nearly 39 years and they're still as loving and as loyal as ever. It's their love that forms the bedrock of our happy, supportive and loving family, before you know. The only thing we're missing today was Chantelle. I've been told that for the perfect speech, I need to tell some funny stories about Luke. We've had some funny times over the years, but half of these stories can never be talked about in public. As you all know, Luke is very caring and would always offer to help a helping hand to anyone. I have one word of warning though. Do not ask Luke for help if you are eating or drinking around him. If you didn't know this, try it. It's the very best way of ending a telephone call or even being deleted on Facebook.
I got deleted for you.
But there is an interesting story of when we was really young, because that's as far back as I could go without talking about anything crazy. So when we were young, Luke and I decided between ourselves there'd be a good idea to see how much water we could keep in the shower. So Luke went off for a shower, foot firmly over the plug hole. I then took over. It was going so well, the water was nearly up to my waist. Then I heard this really strange noise, which now was my mum screaming. Followed by my dad sprinting up the stairs. The kitchen ceiling had collapsed. And I got all of the blame. No, I can't have a lot of fault.
You started.
But then I got told, the next thing about the speech, I got told I should mention some of my duties as best man. So you think as best man you'd arrange a stag do. I wasn't allowed. Because he didn't want me to go to afternoon tea. We ended up in a night out in Birmingham. I'd like to thank everybody for coming and making it very memorable. It was a night out full of laughs, culture and sightseeing. Well, there wasn't much culture, but there was certainly some sight. Another duty was to get Luke to church on time. Not an easy task when both of our timekeepers were so poor, but thankfully we made it before Chantelle. I suppose this is the right time to say, Luke, thank you for making it easy to be your best man. I was told at the reception the best man should keep things running smoothly by offering round drinks and introducing people. I don't mind the socialising part, but the cost of Jager bombs and pina coladas and it in a break. As everyone will know, Luke, our dad, and myself quite like a little gamble on the horses. We have little meetings over Sunday dinner and generally make fun of each other. I get the impression this place was only booked because they got a brew machine in the bar, which Luke or my dad has probably already emptied, so I wouldn't think about wrong with it. Okay, so I've heard it's tradition to offer you some advice in your marriage. And I think you should never be complacent. You should always keep an eye out for them telltale signs in your relationship. Like if you see the milkman wearing your socks. I spent the last few months worrying about this speech, but the point of it only came to me yesterday. And that is, nobody could possibly stand where I am right now and feel more proud and honoured than me to be able to represent Luke on the most important day of his life, even if he wanted to wear shorts. I've already had both of them in my life for quite a long time, and I look forward for many, many more years. It gives me great, immense pleasure, not to mention relief, to invite you all to stand and raise a glass to the new bride and groom.
Congratulations.
Yeah, you just
pretend
to drink
your. Mother Shad.
Your turn now, Shad.
No,
I'm your turn.
Ladies and gentlemen, please pray silence for the brother of the bride.
We didn't know that. It's good to know.
This is totally off the cuff. It wasn't planned. This is mining for my dad. I didn't want to do it in the first place. But first, I want to say how gorgeous Chantelle looks today, and all the bridesmaids and everyone here today. Such a beautiful occasion. And of course, groom's mother and father. Superb. I loved you too bad as well. There's a few stories I'd like to take. I'm not going to go into it too bad, but my brother Lee knows. Chantelle, kids, cover your ears. When Chantelle was little, anything that went wrong in the house was always me and his fault. Me and her brother. Dad. Chantelle's done this, done this. It's always got the blame, me and him did. Always running to mum and dad. And dad used to say to me, "What have you done now, Darren? What have you done, Lee, now? What have you done? What have you done?" Always got the blame. But she's grown up to be a beautiful young woman and a fantastic bride. I'm so glad to welcome Luke to the family. Great young man. Don't be afraid. Also, I'd like to say, some of the people that can't be here today, people we've lost. My cousin Claire, close to Chantelle. My uncle Bobby recently. My auntie Betty, people like that. Can't be here. It's a shame, but I'm sure they would have loved, of course, my granddad as well. They would have loved this occasion. They would have been really proud of you, Shan. Really, really proud. So, first of all, I'd like to raise a glass. If you can stand up and raise a glass to all those people. I know it's been said before, all these people that can't be with us, my granddad, my cousin, my aunt, my uncle. So if you can, please. Thank you very much. Thank you. You can all sit back there now. Can you draw the group in a minute? And just on a lighter note, Villa won today. Ta-ra!
Dance floor. I'm going to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Wilson to the dance floor for their first dance together as a married couple. Make some noise, come on!
My love's give out. I promise to dance, we fight like in a vow.
Who taught you the dance moves?